Hi friends, welcome back to Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Today I'll show you how I make Mangalorean style beef sukka. This is another dish which is close to my heart. This is how my dad would prepare the dish, biting into the selected chunks of beef cooked along with masala is a heavenly feeling. Beef sukka is delicious, spicy, almost dry dish with very little masala or gravy. You will find quite a few beef recipes on my channel, and this one is special dish that you will definitely relish for its flavorful aroma and texture. The lip smacking dish tastes delicious with ghee rice, jeera rice, or with plain dal rice. You can also relish this dish with hot chapatis and a salad. Mom would always make a gravy with potatoes so that the dish could be stretched throughout the day, and dad would ask her to make this type of sukka. So let's check out the ingredients. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. If you like this recipe of mine, do give a thumbs up and click the like button. If you have tried this recipe, please leave a comment in the comment section below. So let's get started. Here I have taken 9 Kashmiri chilies. This is a mix of Kashmiri and Bedgi. You can either use Kashmiri or own Bedgi. This is around 15 peppercorns, 3-4 teaspoons of mustard seeds, 3-4 teaspoons of cumin seeds, 4 cardamom pods, 5 cloves, 1 inch piece of cinnamon stick, 1 tablespoon coriander seeds, dry roasted. You need not add any oil, but see that the flame is on sim. Do not brown them. If it gets burnt, the masala, the curry will taste different. Switch off the flame now. Add 1 teaspoon of poppy seeds or kashkash. This is optional. If it is not available in your part of the country, you can avoid it. This is a small ball of tamarind. Remember, we have switched off the flame. This is 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder. See that, keep on stirring, otherwise the turmeric powder tends to get burnt. This is 4 garlic flakes. Grind the masala to a fine paste. Do not add much water while grinding. Now this is 1 kg of beef. There are a few bones in it. The bones will release their own juice and it is flavorful. This is 1.5 piece of ginger, finely chopped, around 6 green chilies. These are not very spicy. 1 large tomato, 2 large onions sliced, around 6 to 8 garlic flakes. Cut everything finely, add it to the beef. And add salt as per taste. Give it a nice good mix and then you can cook it. I pressure cook it for just 2 whistles, but it depends. If the meat is tough, you will have to pressure cook it for a little longer. This is the boiled meat. The water has almost dried up. I didn't add any water while cooking. It should be quite dry. If any water, please dry it out. This is 1 large onion sliced. In the pot, add oil as per your requirement and fry the sliced onion till it is nice and soft. You need not brown them completely. Add a few curry leaves. curry leaves brings out the nice flavor in the dish. Once the onion is nice golden in color, then you can add the ground masala and just fry it for a few minutes. Remember, we have already roasted the masala, so you just have to fry till it is well combined and you can see a little oil separating from the sides. At this point of time, you can add a little salt if there is less in the meat, otherwise add accordingly. This is a dry dish. If you want, you can add a little water, but this is quite dry. It is usually served with jeera rice, ghee rice. Add around 1 tablespoon of vinegar. This is optional, but it brings out the flavor and taste, enhances the taste. You can make it with only beef pieces or with bone-in meat. Either way, it tastes great. Do give it a try. I'm sure you too will enjoy this yummy beef sukka. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel and do not forget to click the bell icon to get notified when I upload a new recipe. The list of ingredients is given in the description box below. So my sweet friends, hope you have enjoyed this quick and yummy recipe. Stay tuned for more such interesting recipes. Till we meet again, check out my other recipes at Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Bye, see you soon with the new interesting recipe. Take care.